What if medicine wasn't just about treating illness, but stopping it before it even begins?
There is a huge misconception about one's health that they're not aware of.
At this futuristic clinic, they're trying to do exactly that. Zoy Health Center uses digital and physical tools to create predictive algorithms about your health. This is combined with behavioral science and a mobile app to nudge you into making the right choices for your future. Méline is here to find out whether this focus on architecture and the client's experience is as important as Zoy's team claims. Méline is in Paris to visit Zoy. The clinic is discreetly tucked behind a black door near Place Vendôme, inside a 20,000 square foot sanctuary. Created by entrepreneur Paul Dupuis, here, materials, light, and sound are used to calm the senses, to rehumanize the medical journey, from colonnaded vestibules and softly lit corridors to 18 oval examination suites where technology is hidden from sight. Onsens, pools carved from volcanic stone, are designed as decompression chambers, inviting reflection for clients before stepping back into the city. Here, she's meeting Théo Deschamps-Pujot.
Hi, Méline, good to see you. Welcome to Zoy.
Hi.
With a background in raising millions in venture funding, he now helps shape Zoy's vision of preventative healthcare.
So could you tell us a little bit about the philosophy of Zoy? What is the journey for the client in general?
Zoy means life in Greek. If you want to extend your health span, it's not what will happen in this room, but what you will be doing afterwards that will have an impact. We wanted to provide you with an experience that is inspiring. This is why we built this building, is when you come in, you get out of your daily life and you have the feeling of doing something truly exceptional. By doing so, when you come out of the clinic, you will want to follow the next steps. You will want basically your health to belong to Zoy, and you will want to follow the recommendation from Zoy. So this is why we wanted to create this exceptional space. When you arrive at the center, you will spend 2.5 hours here in the suite, where nurse and doctors will start with a full body echography, for instance. Then we will do dozens of different exercises. We'll check your heart, obviously, your tension, your eyes, your ears, everything. And then we will use a CBCT scan to scan your face and your lungs. We'll do a DEXA scan to scan your body composition. And we'll also do an OCT scan to scan your eyes and your optical nerves. After the whole checkup, which is only the beginning of the journey, our doctors will provide you with your body's manual, which is basically a simple action plan to change the way you live, the way you eat, the way you sleep, to improve your daily life and extend your health span.
And the follow-up will be the whole year.
The success for us is when you follow the recommendation and you change the way you live, indeed, and see the results. You have 5 kinds of recommendation, whether it's food, whether it's supplements, therapeutics, sports and activities, and then what we call daily habits. In your Zoy application, we look at your calendar and ping you with the right action to do at the right moment. If, for instance, you can scan your money when you're at the restaurant, and we say, hey, given your microbiote and given your immunity, you should try to boost those things and you should take the fish, for instance.
This is your personal health app, so that from all year round you can know what's happening in your body.
Exactly, and you can obviously, if you have question or if you need to be in touch with your Zoy's doctor to ask him question, you can do it through the app as well. You have a chat, and if you need to call him, you can call him as well.
Clearly, the architecture of this whole building and whole space is very special, and we are located very, very central in Paris. Could you tell us why this place had to be designed in such a way?
So the design is quite unique. We wanted to do it as close as possible to the actual nature. So if you look at the room, there is no angle. We try to avoid the angle. If you look at the lighting as well at the ceiling, this is a reproduction of actual light that you could find in nature. The sounds, we worked with a music designer that gathered sound from the forests and made it a music for the sender as well, and the scent is the same. We did it with natural scent. The goal is for you to feel like you were in the nature for two main reasons. The first one is when you're relaxed, we can gather data of higher quality. So this experience also contributes to the results that we will get from the checkup. The second reason is the checkup is only the beginning of the journey. We want you to have an exceptional experience so that you want to keep going, you want to follow up, and you want to implement your action plan when you leave the facility.
What are the misconceptions that you see people have towards health?
There is a huge misconception about one's health. I would say the biggest one is their awareness about their own health. Out of four members that come here, 46% of them have a pathology that they do not know, that they're not aware of. So a lot of people are ignoring weak signals. For instance, if you have a hard time concentrating after lunch, it can mean that you're dopamine deprived, for instance. If you have a hard time in the morning waking up and starting your day, again, it can be the testimonial of many things. We had a member came in C-level of a big French company, actually, and he said, "I'm all right, just a little bit tired when I wake up." And actually, we found out that his thyroid was not working at all.
And when you see the future 10 years or 20 years of the healthcare, where do you think we are going?
These kind of checkups will be a baseline for everybody, and that's what we're working toward at Zoe. We want to make it accessible to the greater numbers. So we want everybody not only to do checkup, but I think that we'll be able to monitor one's health continuously. We already see connected watch, connected rings that are coming in. It's becoming easier and easier. So I think we'll be able to live monitor your health, and I think we'll be able to do basically what we call digital twin, which is the status of your body, how it should be versus how it actually is. And we'll be able, from the differences, to deduce any disease, any risk, and we'll be able to be in a real predictive healthcare. So yeah, this is the vision we see at Zoe.
What inspired you to work here? And after you work here, is there any change in your personal health?
Oh yeah, definitely. So everybody at Zoe gets to do the checkup. When I did mine, I went to the doctor and told him, "Listen, I believe I'm in pretty good health. It's been 10 years that I've been a hard time sleeping. Sometimes I had insomnia, but I think it's correlated to stress." And so I did my checkup, and when I received the results, the doctor started with, "Good news, your stress is on point. You're stressing perfectly right." But the thing is, I had a lot of deficiency in my nutrition, and I was lacking vitamins, I was lacking omega, I was lacking acid amine, which created an imbalance where my body was burning melatonin too fast. So basically, when I were to go to sleep, I was chemically not able to fall asleep. And this is the 360 degree checkup that told me this. I had some supplements. I changed the time of the day when I eat, and now I haven't had an insomnia in the past 6 months.
Wow.
So yeah, it made a huge difference to me personally.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching this new episode of the HumanWare Project. So that we can bring out more amazing content like this one, please like and subscribe. Your subscription means the world to us.